tackle next. He is waiting for us at Sadik Station. Go ahead. I will join you there. I'm afraid we have done too much. The British Indies Company is trying to capture your train.
Agnes, I hope she's all right.
Not to worry. I'll take care of these troublemakers.
I can handle the rest of them. What's up with your train?
Mr. Bean should be at Whitechapel Station.
The train is too far away. I need to grab a carriage. Singh should have a carriage nearby. Keep moving. I knew I hadn't seen the last of you. I must board the train. Could jump on the train from this bridge.
Here. We are here. We are here. We are here. What a catastrophe.
The BIC must not be very happy with how things are progressing.
You could say that.
But at least that quieted them down. For now.
Perhaps this is not the best time to bring up what I called you here for. I have another plan.
Go on, then.
It may sound mad, but I propose we steal Koh-i-Noor Diamond.
Doesn't that belong to the Queen?
Her Majesty may wear it, but it doesn't belong to her. It was a trophy, symbolizing the colonization of India, and it deserved to be returned home. It would be an extremely delicate mission, but I know you'd be more than capable of such a feat. I have already procured some information pertaining to the location of the Koh-i-Noor. Come and find me when you've had a moment to think it over. I put my ear to the ground and found someone who may know the location of the Koh-i-Noor Diamond.
Excellent. Heisen, my favorite.
A man by the name of Cornelius Toti Button.
Beer drinker. What? I can tell.
He is apparently a friend of the royal jeweler.
How will we find him?
He frequents a pub in the City of London Borough called The George.
Sounds like the sort of man I know how to deal with.
Don't be ridiculous.
Fret not, dearest sister. I will take care of this one on my own.
Come find me in Westminster when you have the information we need.
Not with the royal jeweler this evening. It's a shame to drink alone.
Whatever it is you want from me, I'm not interested. What I am interested in is ordering another pint.
I'll tell you what. If I can outdrink you, you tell me where the famous Koh-i-Noor Diamond is located.
You think you can drink me under the table? That's a lot to wager on a losing battle.
I'll take that as an accepted challenge, then. Barkeep, 2 pints over here.
Much better.
Oi, my God. What happened last night? Well, I'll never make it back to the train in this state. I'll have to try to remember what happened. I know I was at a pub, but which one?
Ah, you survived the night, I see. I wasn't sure what would become of you.
You're back! I thought I'd seen the last of you when you sauntered off to that shooting competition.
Keep your hands.
You won't get away with it.
The name of the game is...
Shoot the bottle?
Precisely. Can you do it?
Can you tell me where the diamond is?
You have to beat me at this first. right way. That old flicker as well as you thought. Range is a pretty good shot. That's too bad. Bad. You're a good shot. Better than I ever would have guessed. Good shot. You're a good shot. Better than I ever would have guessed. We're done with this pub, but not done for the night. On to the Bricklayer's Arms with you, jolly boy. Follow me.
It's Jacob.
Did you see that? Who did that?
Who did what? Never mind, Cornelius. Just tell me where the diamond is.
Someone spilled it. Some bastard spilled my beer.
Listen.
I needed the money.
Beer!
Fine. I'll find the fool that did this.
Much better.
Sour bunch, dwindling in number, but absolute terrors in this particular neighborhood. By Jove! Spill someone's drink? Why would I ever do such a nasty thing?
What about them? I hate those bastards. They love to terrorize me. You need to do something about them. I was talking to that yarn-spinning oaf, Dickens, when I turned back to my drink, and it's all over the place. I bet you good money those evil blighters did this.
The pettiest thing someone can do, if you ask me. You have to have one ugly personality to do that, you do. The pettiest thing someone can do, if you ask me. You have to have one ugly personality to do that, you do.
Thank you.
One for the books, or so I heard. Lots of sweat, blood, and tears last night. Those blighters can put on quite a show. Walk away with full pockets from those games they do. One for the books, or so I heard. Lots of sweat, blood, and tears last night. Those blighters can put on quite a show. Walk away with full pockets from those games they do.
You've got the wrong man. I haven't played a game of cards in a dog's age.
Last night's game? Why, I won that fair and square. If Cornelius is still going on about that, he deserves a kick in the mouth. His money is mine and there's nothing he can do about it.
Which leg? This one? Why, you can hardly tell.
You think I spilled my own beer? Ludicrous! Wait, well, maybe I did.
There he is! Come fight me like a real man! Skins and fists!
Those are the largest shits I've ever seen!
We'd better get out of here before they start asking for more.
Well, that was a bit frightening now, wasn't it? I think I'm gonna be sick.
None of that now. Come, let's get you home.
I don't think I can stand.
You must be joking.
This one you always into. If I were 10 years younger, I'd teach you something bigger too, I would. What is this other man on it?
Oh, no, please don't kill me! Your purse, drunkard! Give up your purse!
Help me! What did I do to deserve this? Oh, Joseph, I'm so glad to have a friend to join me.
You're the name
of your club!
Let's make them sorry for poking their nose in the wrong places.
We had such fun. We should do this every night.
Are you still talking?
I think I overdid it tonight. Oh well, I'll sleep it off. This is my place. You're a good drinker, you know. You might be better than me.
I am. And never you forget it.
Good night, then. Julia.
But wait. At least I know where to find him. Where is that button fool?
job to do.
How did you get up here? I walked you home.
Jacob?
Finally. Now tell me, where is the bloody diamond?
Does this technically count as winning? All right, all right. It's in the Tower of London. Surprise. Being held there until tonight's gala finishes, and then it will be shipped back to the Royal Jeweler for another cutting.
Many thanks. Come on. Buttons.
Now hold on right there.
You're late?
Me? Never. I was simply retrieving the information you sent me to get. It was easy, really. Something about an event happening tonight at the Tower of London.
The gala? I will be attending.
Your hour in, then.
You can't just barge in and steal the crown jewels.
She's right. We need a plan.
Oh, bother.
Jacob, you can escort Mr. Singh to tonight's event. This will give you a chance to slip away from the party and find the Koh-i-Noor. I'll take care of the guards around the perimeter. Meet me at the top of the White Tower.
Good! Another chance to wear the suit.
No weapons allowed.
Where's the fun in that? I should find Singh.
The jewels are being held upstairs, but be careful. If this isn't one of the most heavily guarded places, then I'm a true Englishman.
I may need your help to distract these guards.
Just give me the signal. Come quick. Madam Butterworth has fainted.
We need some real authority.
The very notion that a person of my status should be accosted in this manner. The indignity. So unjustly. Do you expect to get away with this?
We pass the royal household to Mr. Starrick and put our life in some hands with actual agency.
The diamond is on the second floor. Awfully quiet up here.
Somebody stop that impetuous being.
Thank you.
Guards asleep. I wonder what's inside that crate. Someone got here before I did. Well, if the diamond's not here, I've got to find it before it leaves the building, if it hasn't already. Where could it have gone?
We'll see you.
This plan was genius. We'll get him this time.
Friends with the Queen? Ha! She won't be friends with him when she finds the diamond is in his pocket.
He'll never see it coming.
Once he tries to walk out that door, he'll kiss his royal title goodbye.
And henceforth be known as Prisoner C.
They planted the diamond on the leap? Not good.
You flatter me, ma'am.
Now, tell me, how do you two know each other?
We met at the missionary compound in Patagon, Your Majesty. The Loggins were quite fond of the Ellsworths.
It was a lonely time on foreign soil for me. I was more than happy to have a friend.
I'm sure.
Now to find my sister.
And now the company has sent you...
Someone's...
far did you make it?
Good riddance. Who do you suppose did this? You were a good soldier.
Ha!
What took you so long?
Bit of a mishap. Here it is.
What happened?
Somebody stole it first. The safe had been robbed by the time I got there.
The British Indies Company will stop at nothing.
There was a plan to frame Singh. I lifted it from him before the Royal Guards found it. Imagine the look on Her Majesty's face if...
They must know by now that their plan was foiled.
You're welcome.
I think it's time to depart. I need to find a way out of here. I hope they make it out all right.
Did you get it to your sister?
Just barely.
What do you mean?
I'll tell you about it another time.
You encountered some trouble?
We can't speak of this here. The British Indies Company is up to no good again.
Outside, then.
You, sir! Halt for inspection!
I beg your pardon?
Search him!
Nothing. The coroner isn't here.
Of course there's nothing. What do you take me for?
Some sort of criminal?
A long time, hasn't it? Where to begin?
Oh, this must be the dress you brought.
What was all that commotion about, Mr. Singh?
I do believe they thought I was trying to pinch the Koh-i-Noor, Your Ladyship.
Ha! Huh? The Koh-i-Noor? Who on earth would want to steal that potato? Good night, Your Highness.
We barely got out of there in one piece. The British Indies Company tried to plant the diamond on you and frame you for stealing it. Luckily, I was there just in the nick of time.
We need to meet back at Mr. Green's shop. I must see the diamond with my own two eyes.
The Koh-i-Noor, if I may.
Glass?
The real Koh-i-Noor never left India. Had I known you planned to reclaim it, I would have stopped you. My father ensured it never fell into Templar hands.
Your father, he has done a great service to me and my people.
My words to you earlier were unfair.
You were not wrong. I, too, have grown frustrated with my lack of progress. Shall we let bygones be bygones?
We need to find out who's behind all of this, and why the Templars and the British Indies companies have joined forces.
What we should do is track them down and destroy their headquarters.
Jacob.
That may not be such a terrible idea, Mr. Fry. I spoke with Mr. Green, and we have discovered the location of the British Indies secret headquarters. You are to meet him, and he will give you the details. There is a foundry nearby where the Templars and BIC members have been meeting on a regular basis. Mr. Green waits for you there.
But we still don't understand why they tried to frame you.
We don't, but Mr. Green seemed to think that they're using the factory to develop something. It's a good place to start digging. Good luck.
Huh.
see someone.
Right now, look up.
You made it.
You found the British Indies Company hideout?
They've taken over an abandoned foundry. It's heavily fortified, and word has it, they're shipping something precious overseas.
My gut tells me that something precious is something bad.
My thoughts exactly. Go find out what they're protecting and destroy it. Maybe you'll discover why they're after Mr. Singh.
So this is where they've been keeping that sleeping gas. They can't leave London.
No place for you.
Can I be complete?
They're shipping this to India? No. What do they want this for? War? I must destroy them. Ooh.
with you. This will not go unanswered.
What happened here?
The Templars
rest
try
in
and
peace,
feet.
My friend.
Oh God! Someone
ride
help!
Back away, if I were you.
I could have sworn he...
gotta get the boss. We've got a problem.
Yes. Go fetch the manager. Is that Ellsworth? I'd better get a closer look.
Destroyed? How?
There's someone in the vicinity! A spy! One of those rogues, I wager!
It must be those damned renegades Singer's friends with. Who knew one caged bird could cause so much trouble?
You're caught, Ellsworth. Give up.
I knew you had something to do with this. Seize him!
Damn it. He got away. I must tell Singh of this news immediately.
What did you find out? Who's behind all of this?
You're not gonna like what I have to tell you, Your Highness. Brinley Ellsworth is behind the attacks.
Ellsworth?
He was gone before I had a chance to follow him. But we need to track him down and put an end to this before anything worse happens.
I need some time to think on this. When you said that this was our chance.
I was.
I propose we make a commotion. Lure out the Templar-controlled British Indies Company.
And do what? Put yourself in the line of fire?
I need to send Ellsworth a message. This won't be over until we can lure him out. This is something I must do. I will make a scene. and then you need to rough them up a little.
Well, that shouldn't be a problem.
I've heard you Templars are a bunch of pansies.
Here we go.
Break him into pieces!
Send a message to Elsworth.
I'll do anything!
Oh my God! Someone
tell him to call me! To meet me at Lambeth Cemetery tonight and tell him
someone
to come alone.
Out.
Someone gets shot before my very eyes and I can't turn
the edge. I should. Help! Someone apprehend the murderer!
Meet me tonight at Lambeth Cemetery. He'll never come alone, even if I ask him to.
But you see it for yourself? Oh, it's something very
worse. The gracious has been a killing!
Don't say that again!
Oh,
shit!
Goodness, no!
Out of the damn way!
He's in my line of sight!
Throw everything you have!
That caused quite a commotion.
He's gone mad. Greeny was right.
He isn't mad, Jacob. He's trying to take action. To do the right thing. Oh, never mind. I'll take it from here.
Fine by me. I could use a good pint right about now.
Oh, I was expecting Jacob, but I'm glad it's you who have come.
He thinks you've gone mad.
I probably have.
What's your plan?
I've asked Brinley to meet me here alone. In turn, he, of course, has sent a small army to secure the area. I need you to get rid of them and meet me back here. It's essential that when Brinley does arrive, I have him to myself.
Understood.
That'll certainly help quite a bit, thank you.
He's here.
I must talk to him.
Don't be absurd, this is dangerous.
Miss Fry, this is something I must do, and I must do it alone. Remain hidden. I cannot afford to have him see you.
You can't escape me forever, Your Highness. Come out and face me. This meeting place alone, but with your recently acquired friends.
I am alone, Elswood.
You can't just walk this earth like a free man. You are nothing more than a trophy, a stag's head above a mantelpiece. You've caused enough commotion as it is. It's time to put an end to this.
Elswith, listen.
I've had enough of this.
I knew you were lying.
No, you mustn't!
He will kill you!
This is what I was sent here for. Be done with it, girl! I shall never forfeit my own mission.
I will not allow it.
The Loggins, the company, they all wanted your silence. Whether you spare me or end me, you won't escape the fate they have planned for you.
It seems you have learnt nothing of India, of its people. But killing you? That is something I cannot do. It would make me no better than the cursed, oppressive company you work for. Yeah.
You will die as you were raised, Singh. You'll never be more than a trophy of war. We will bury you in English soil.
You have done me much good. I am heavily indebted to you both.
We are happy to help.
I fear that I cannot continue handling things in this manner. The assassin way is not my way. As helpful as you have been, this empire, this land, my people, the problem is so much bigger than death. I know I must devote my life to this cause, to put India, my home, back onto the map, return it to its people. It's a long and grueling journey, but it is something I must do, even if it takes me to my own death.
We understand, Your Highness.
But if you do change your mind, you know where to find us.
That I do. Thank you, assassins. Hopefully we never shall meet again.